Mason Francis Kirchhoff Aqua Vitae. This is just the regular Aqua Vitae. This is not the Forte EDP. This is the Eau de Toilette that I'm talking about here. And I want to do a quick little review on this one before we get completely into winter, because there are some days here where it's still a little bit warm. So I figured why not go ahead and get a review out before the end of the season. So guys, let's go ahead and jump right into this fragrance. Right when I first spray it, I get a lemon and orange combination of citrus. It's a very nice, authentic smell. It doesn't come across as synthetic or sharp. It's very smooth and they mix together nicely. Now out of those two, I pick up on the lemon more so than the orange, but again, they are blended very well together and I can definitely tell they're both there, but lemon does stick out a little bit more to my nose. Almost immediately following after that, I start to pick up on some vanilla and some tonka bean, which gives it a nice, smooth, and creamy background. It does give it a lot of depth, because with a lot of fragrances that have a lot of citrus, they don't always have that depth and they can be kind of transparent, they can be a little bit boring, but because of the vanilla and the tonka bean in this fragrance, it gives it a lot of depth and character, and I really like that. It's smooth, it's creamy, it's just a little bit sweet, it's a little bit fresh, it's got a little bit of a citrus pop to it. It's just a very pleasing fragrance, and that's really about it. It smells very nice, it's very pleasing. Is this one that's going to blow you away? Probably not. Is this one of my favorite MFKs? No, it's not. This one probably doesn't even make it into my top five currently. It's pleasant. Like I said, it smells good, but it doesn't blow me away. And I don't think this type of scent is really supposed to blow you away. The longer it sits on your skin, the more that vanilla and the tonka starts to come through, continuing to sweeten it up. And I also get a little bit of a clean clothes type of smell, like almost like a fabric softenery type of smell. Just a little bit though. It's not quite like Aqua Universalis, but it does have a little bit of this clean clothes type of smell. Now, as far as versatility for this fragrance, it's not the most versatile fragrance. Really, for me, it's only for spring and summer casual wear. Now, ideally, you could wear this pretty much whenever you want because of just how simple it is and how inoffensive it is. But for me, it really is just a scent that I would wear in the spring and summer, just, you know, to throw it on and go throughout my day just casually. It's not something I would wear to a formal dinner or to a date, just a casual scent for the warm months of the year. As far as performance goes on this one, it again is not the best. Longevity, I get around 5 to 6 hours. Projection wise, it sits pretty close to the skin. I don't find myself picking up whiffs that often throughout the day, so definitely it's on the lower side, on the lower end as far as performance goes overall. If you want something that is going to perform better, I would recommend that you look into the Forte version, which is an EDP. Personally, I have not tried it, but from what I understand, those perform a lot better. But it will also smell a little bit different. I've heard from some people that say the Forte is a little bit more feminine, so you would be better off getting a sample of both and, you know, figuring out which one you like. But if performance is a deal breaker for you, if you need something that performs really, really good, this one's not going to be the one. Like I said, very, very moderate to slightly below average performance. With a scent like this, do I care all that much? Not really. I'll reapply it. I've got the 200 mil, so I'm not too worried about, you know, having to conserve this. I'll reapply it because I enjoy the scent, but it is kind of a bummer that when you are paying this much for a fragrance that it doesn't last longer. Now, will this get you compliments? Yeah, I'm sure it will. If people can smell it on you, that is, then you might get some comments here and there saying that you smell nice. But again, that's the big catch with this one, if people smell you. And again, on me, not the best performing, so, you know, it's kind of a toss-up whether or not it's going to pull good compliments. But it's a clean smelling scent, it's inoffensive, citrus with a little bit of a creamy backbone. There's really nothing to dislike about this fragrance at all, so it will get you compliments if people can smell you. Alright guys, that about sums up my thoughts on Aqua Vitae, the Eau de Toilette version by Mason Francis Kirchhoff. Again, really nice scent. Do I think you should try it? If you're into citruses with a little bit of a creamy background, I would say definitely give it a shot. It's worth trying. Just don't be expected to be blown away by it. It's, again, not one of my favorite MFKs. There are multiple I would choose over this one, but it is still a good scent. I'm happy to have it, and it'll be one that I pull out every now and then in the spring and summer when I'm just feeling like reaching for something random. So guys, that's gonna do it for this review. I'll leave a link down below to my eBay store where I am selling decants of this if you do want to try it out. But anyways guys, that's gonna do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, leave a like down below. Also, forget to subscribe and turn on post notifications so you don't miss when I post. Dropping videos almost every single day on fragrances, so make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. That way you see the videos. And that's it guys, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.